Did you know him, Shelley?
Every Italian.
Right. And it won all the festivals, you know, in Europe, in Italian. And we loved it so much that we put English lyrics to it. And it's a new record, and I think it's smashing. I hope you like it, really. Tonight I set the table. I'll take my chair. I'll act like nothing's happened, though you're not there. I'll smile when Johnny asks me why you are so late. I'll tell him Daddy's busy, but I wonder and worry and wait. Tonight I'll write some letters, they're overdue. I'll look at television, but I'll see you. I'll think about this morning, of our silly, foolish fight, the way you said I won't be home tonight. Tonight I'll kiss your pillow when I'm in bed. I'll blame myself completely for what I said. My eyes will fill with teardrops when I think of you. I'll feel so lost and lonely, 'cause I love you, I love you, I love you. Tonight I'll say a prayer for you wherever you may be, and hope that when I wake tomorrow you'll be here with me. Oh, how can I live without you? You're all I'm thinking of. Tonight I'll say a prayer for you, my love. How can I live without you? You're all I'm thinking of. Tonight I'll say a prayer for you, my love. Oh, how can I live without you? You're all I'm thinking of. Tonight I'll say a prayer for you, my love. La 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 la. How can I live without you? You're all I'm thinking of. Tonight a song, and particularly if they like a performer, they never let you sing alone. Did you know that? And I would love you to sing this song with me. I really would. Not because I'm standing here begging you, but because sincerely you really want to. Let me hear it out there. La da 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 da
da da da da. Oh yes. La da 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 da. Now just the muggers. The arsonists. Grand larceny.
Da, da.
Gee, that's terrific. la 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 la.
Did I make it?
Oh, you never breathe once.
Well, what about the song? You never breathe once. People aren't supposed to see you breathe when you sing. You sneak it in. Sneak it in, Shelley. You just can't go.
You sound like one of my Italian husbands.
Actually,
is that the response you got?
It's very, very hard to sing when you have a nasal drip.
Well, isn't that post exciting?
Post or pre?
What about Arthur?
No,
no, pre is
MAME. Why didn't you ever do MAME, and MAME, you know, this, on Broadway? You sing that song better than anybody in the world. Why shouldn't you do MAME? You really should, just because it's acting and you're so smart. Never mind the commercial, Merv.
La, la, la.
You should just...
This is a chorus, girl. What's the blending cycle review from Oster?
Oh, I love it. I love it.
Osterizer's got a way with blending. Spin cookery that's so precise. Gives everything you blend a happy ending. Everything's bound to come out nice. With control cycle blending. Control cycle blending. Control cycle blending.
Controlled cycle blending means the combination of a wide selection of blending speeds, plus unique on-off push-button control for the all-important cycling action. It's what makes the difference between the beautiful and the blah in blending. Key to successful spin cookery. Give it a whirl.
Everything's bound to come out nice with control cycle blending. Control cycle blending. Control cycle blending.
See the full line of Osterizer controlled cycle blenders. There's one for every budget at better appliance and department stores everywhere.
Gorgeous. That's really great.
What'd you say?
Pretty good. Yeah. We're comparing rings.
It's like a hen party, isn't it, Arthur?
I think so. I like it.
Oh, Arthur, your cufflinks are beautiful.
Aren't they?
Yes, and your tie clasp.
And you
oh, pardon me, that soup.
What, dear?
You have no jewelry on, Merv. Yes, no. No,
I say, don't. Merv, where's your brassiere?
I've been cleaned out recently. That's
where's your brassiere? Really? You know, the one I gave you.
You mean cummerbund, we call them here in America,
yes.
Arthur.
You have to move
get me out of here. It's a perfect time. Here's one of the weirdest comedians in the whole business. Perfect for tonight. Here's Adam Keefe. Adam.
Oh, my. Thank you very much. You know, I think that almost everybody has a favorite comedian, and mine has always been Troy Donahue. You know. But anyway, for a change of pace, right now I'd like to do two pantomimes for you. This is my impression of two silent movies that I saw at the Museum of Modern Art on Fifth Avenue. You know, I took my wife there, but they wouldn't accept her. They said, it's beautiful, but where are we going to hang it? You know, it's a lousy attitude that they have. I only took her down to the basement to see the movies, really. And we were so lucky, because the day we went, we saw two of the great stars. First of all, Douglas Fairbanks Sr., of whom it has been said, more than any other man of his time, he alone was responsible for Douglas Fairbanks Jr. But that was only a hobby. See, because his work, his life, his art was the motion picture, and he invented the swashbuckling film. And this is a scene from one of his first films when he was just starting to swash and beginning to buckle. Here's a scene from Buckle My Swash.
Thank you.
You know, here's... excuse me. Anyway... Here's John Barrymore.
Where?
He's not here. Well, some nights he shows up. This is my impression of... This is my impression of John Barrymore, the great profile. And I do both sides. Here he is as both Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde in a scene from two of his finest films, Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde. Anytime you're ready, CB. Here's a short impression of an entire movie. This is a picture. I didn't see this at the museum. I saw this at a place that should be a museum, my neighborhood theater, which is the Lugza Theater in the Bronx in New York City. There's a few fans. See, they know the Lugza Theater. Well, that's where I was born, in the Lugza Theater. I think I was born there. I don't know, but they found me under a seat. Anyway, business lately hasn't been too good at the Lugza, because if... A few days ago, I called him up, and I said, what time does the show start? And he said, when can you get here, you know? That's insecurity, you know. I think one of the reasons for that is the films they get are so old, you know? I mean, when they get a movie, everybody else has already had it, you know? And it's been broken a million times and glued together again. But when they get it, a strange thing happens. It breaks again, and they glue it. The one I saw broke, and they glued it. And then it broke, and they glued it. And 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 it broke, and they stapled it. But that broke the machine, so they glued the machine and stuck to the film. Well, the movie was originally called Northside 777. Only on their machine, it just came out. But as it opens, we find Richard Conte in prison again. And in comes Jimmy Stewart. Now, both of their parts have been cut, but glued together. Evan Hines. Seven years, I've been in this lousy, stinking cell, waiting, hoping, praying for somebody. But now, please, poison my kids. What is that? Who taught you, dirty?
Well, just a gigolo. Just wait a minute now, we check. Just,
this part wasn't cut.
Just a bit. Ooh, that's what I can't believe, you see. Well, I detect a better eyes than your wife and your honor. On behalf of his wife and your dirty, please be here at the door. And I intend to call for the stand at this time, ladies and gentlemen. My surprise in conclusion. I simply, it was poor old mother scrubbing the paint lady out there in your room, and you'll find passage in the desert. Yeah, that's all, folks.
Here's a word from our local station. funny? You like dark?
Oh, I love dark. In fact, I would almost be tempted to take a leg.
Scan if you have some. Oh, that's lovely.
I want a piece of that.
Whitened skin.
Please. And on the, since you said it's so dry.
Boy, this is though. It was
to tune in the Turned On Generation?
Do you love me? I said, do you love me? Well, show me.
I thought you'd never ask.
Hi. I fixed your fuse box.
Like to visit a small town where you're always doggone welcome?
Well, I suppose you are again. Move over.
Like to enjoy a mighty friendly family get-together? Then come by train, come by plane, or come by ladder, by golly. Just be sure to come and get in the comedy's wind every week at Petticoat Junction. Saturday night at 9:30, 8:30 Central Time on the CBS Television Network.
We're about to be joined by a much-talked-about young film star and the man who produced and directed him in the United Artists picture called Gailey Gailey. Beau Bridges is the talented son of actor Lloyd Bridges. He's been touted as filmdom's newest anti-hero. Norman Jewison, of course, is responsible for such films as The Russians Are Coming, The Russians Are Coming in the Heat of the Night, many, many more. Would you welcome Beau Bridges and Norman Jewison? Yeah. Isn't it amazing? Look at that face. How much he looks like Lloyd Bridges.
That's
Norman Jewison. Oh.
Yeah, before you say anything.
And
I
don't
have
start
to...
directing my show.
I have to say.
I know you have. You got your eye on the kid, that's why.
That's right. I was in Hollywood seeing a section of a thing they call a promo for the Exhibitors Convention in Washington of picture I made called, whatever it was, Buddy Mama. And by accident, they were showing a promo of Gailey Gailey. And he's the next big star. Really, since Jimmy Dean.
And you heard it here, Bo.
And the picture's fantastic. It was just the
May promo. I interview him?
Yeah. Could I know him since he's a little boy. He doesn't remember.
Well, then he's up on it. He's
yes,
up
I
on
did.
It a little.
Yeah, I remember.
You shouldn't tell things like
that. I don't want him to know.
Well, I'd like to say something now, Merv. You don't know.
What a great movie star name, though. Bo. That hasn't been used since Brummel.
No, you know where they got that from? Gone with the Wind, my parents. It was some baby's name in Gone with the Wind.
Bo?
Mm-hmm. Bo.
Oh, Beauregard.
Yeah.
Baby Bo.
Was there Beauregard? Yeah.
There was Butterfly McQueen, I remember.
Yeah.
But that's no
name
for
him. Call me that.
Are you excited about it all?
Oh, yeah.
What's the film about?
Well, it's about Ben Heck's life, who is I don't know, some people might not have heard of him. He was a famous journalist who went on it. What are you laughing for?
Well, I think a few people have heard about
Ben
Heck. Well,
some people might not have heard.
It's about a young man who can't lose his virginity.
Go ahead, what?
It's about a young man who has trouble losing his virginity.
You said it a lot better than I could.
It's a little more than that.
Oh, but it was so cute. It was so funny.
Oh,
so
I'm getting such a Excedrin headache 53.
He was so sexy. He really is a doll.
What are some...
Wow.
Remember, you knew him when he was a baby.
I did.
What are some of the songs?
There's no singing at all.
I'm just trying to upset Norman a little bit.
Yeah.
Is there nudity in this film?
No, not very much.
Norman!
Not any more than would be required, you know,
To do what?
No, I am. My backside is naked in the film, actually.
And it's so cute.
What are you applauding?
Merv, today they applaud a knee rash. You
don't
know, it's like
till
incredible.
You've seen it.
Yeah, right.
Yeah. Can I tell you about a scene?
Well, of course you can. You're going to anyway. Can I tell you about a scene?
Well, there's a marvelous scene.
Every word she says.
Yes, speak up, Shelley.
Without the microphone. America can hear me without the microphone. Just open the window.
Have you seen it?
Well, no, I saw a promo, and there was this marvelous scene, and he's so beautiful, and he's crying, and sitting on a bed, and there's this sort of very sexy young prostitute, I think, and he's crying and he's saying, I don't understand how it happened. My first time, and I fell asleep, and he's crying. And she puts her arm around him and says, well, are you sleeping now? It was marvelous.
Oh, I'm sure.
I looked at it better, but it was just marvelous. How did it end? I didn't see the picture. I don't know.
Oh, he woke up. I don't know how it ended. Let's look at a place where everything is fun and games. Well, we've been doing that for a while.
Down.
Very good. This one.
Cake. Birthday. Birthday cake. Rocky.
Simple words.
Horse.
Very good. Fascinating words.
Elephant.
Funny words.
Try this one.
Golden words.
Christmas.
Now children from 4 to 7
Christmas
can unlock the magic of all these words with the best word book ever from Golden Books. And the best storybook ever. And the Golden Storybook Dictionary. Hundreds of pictures give clues to the words. Stories kids love give little readers a big head start. What better gift could you give? Learning to read is golden. Make it your gift.
Daddy, I can read.
Children see a lot in Golden Books.
Diddy Moore Beef Stew is a big meal of lean beef, carrots, potatoes, in a real meat gravy that outbeefs them all for flavor. It's a training table food of the National Football League. Dinty Moore outbeefs the other guys for flavor. From Hormel.
Now you start with beef, good and lean, and you add those good red chili beans, then ripe tomatoes, fresh and bright, and chili spices mixed just right. You simmer them up till the flavors blend, and you've got Hormel chili, friend. Hormel chili. It's not exactly tame.
Norman, when did you come from Canada?
Oh, about 10 years ago.
What was your first television show you directed in America?
Andy Williams.
That's right.
First Andy Williams show.
And then many, many.
Bella Farney.
Judy Garland. Yeah. With Mort Lindsay.
Yes, Mort Lindsay scored, composed, and conducted the first film I did in the States, yeah. 40 Pounds of Trouble.
Right.
Remember that, Mort?
Yeah.
you've just left television.
Yeah.
Don't you like it?
No, I felt it got a little immature around 1960. And I think a lot of people left
1916?
It. 1960. A lot of people left it, you know, and went to film. And because they felt that it got
maybe
so commercial.
Maybe the whole country got immature around 1960.
Yeah. I think television will come back in a much.
That was the year John Kennedy got assassinated.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, wow. 63. But I want you take a young man like Beau Bridges now. Will he be a star?
You don't mind if we talk about you for a minute, Beau?
No, go ahead.
As a director, producer?
I think so. I think it'll depend on if the film captures the imagination of the young people. I think they'll identify, and, you know, we're moving...
Is everything in films done now for the young?